off the floor, right? And cobra, the hips are firmly.
You have your toes facing down.
You can do whatever you want with your toes. Yeah.
Turn it up, dummy.
Yeah. No, I like to turn mine up often, like an up dog. I do. Yeah. Right now my foot's cramping, actually. So
sorry.
I would do that. No,
you don't want you to cramp.
You're not causing the cramp. I'm just saying it depends on what you're doing with your foot. And then you're going to inhale, and you're going to come back into child's pose. Right. Okay, so where you're there again, I want to do this a couple more times. So inhale, find your back bend, arms are straight, shoulders are down, no shoulders up by the ears. Exhale, come back again, breathe out, come back. One more time, breathe in and press your spine forward, your heart up, your shoulders down. Just warming our body up. And then exhale, belly strong as we pull back. We relax into our child's pose. And this is also a posture of devotion. So that's a beautiful word, right? Like, what are we devoted to in our life? Who are we devoted to? There's so many possibilities of devotion. And we're not doing Kundalini here, but in Kundalini, they say, take your commotion and turn it into devotion. And now we're going to come up onto all fours, and we're going to find ragdoll. I like to start the practice with ragdoll. So you're going to come forward, and so many people, I notice, want to have their legs straight here. You get plenty of opportunity to straighten your legs, but you don't get opportunity to let go often. Here's a true opportunity to let go. Let your head go. Let your back go. Let your arms go. Just let go. If you want, you can hold on to your biceps or elbows. If you want, you can sway a little bit side to side. Stay with your breath. That would be a good mantra when he's chanting there for our poses, right? There's a way. Everybody has a way to do the pose. It's not standard, right? Everybody's individual. Now we're going to come back to center. We're going to engage our belly. We're going to let those arms hang. Let the head hang. And inhale, come up. Let your belly bring you up, the strength of your belly. And come up and bring your shoulders back. We are in the mountain posture. This is the foundation of all our postures. How do we stand in the world? Now he's talking about the house by the lake. Yeah, that sounds good. And let's bring our palms together and our thumbs into the center of the chest. We're going to do a few slow sun salutes, right? So inhale through the nose, reach your arms up, palms together or not, gaze forward or up, your choice. You can take a little back bend here if you want or be straight up. And as you exhale, hinge from the hips and fold over. Now we're going to step into a lunge. Inhale, take your right foot back into a low lunge. Look down at those hands as we set them up earlier. Spread your fingers wide. You want a starfish. It's much better for the health of your fingers and your hands and your wrists, right? Spreads the energy out. Now inhale, take your left foot back and you're in plank position. Body is straight and strong. This is one of the most strengthening poses in yoga. Your arms are strong, your torso is strong, your legs are strong, your belly is strong. The gaze is slightly out in front of you. And what some people do is lift their buttocks too much or drop them too much. So try to just stay in line if you can. And now inhale, looking good. And then exhale, we're going back to child's pose. Child's pose. To come forward, you may do a modified push-up. You may do Ashtanga Namaskar, which I will demonstrate to the best of my ability. Or you could do a Chaturanga if you're really wanting to do that. I'm going to do Ashtanga Namaskar, and that is I inhale, take my nose, then my chin, then my chest. Oh, buttocks are up in the air. It opens my chest and upper back to lower my belly and hips. Now I'm keeping my hips on the floor, and it'll be either Sphinx or Cobra. And for my shoulders, it really feels better, though I can do the other one, to hold on to the edge of the mat. And then when I come up, I can press my shoulders down and not feel like I'm scrunching my shoulders. Good, exactly. And so that looks perfect, both of you. And breathe. I know, when you're not
stiff,
when you're not used to doing back bends, you have to practice.
Like
yeah.
Forever.
And then we're going to inhale, and if you're up high, you can go right to down dog. And if you need to, I'll show you the going down, Lisa. You exhale, go down. You bring your hands under your shoulders, and up we go into Adho Mukha Svanasana, our classic downward facing dog. Pull the heels of your feet down and back. Push forward into the heels of your hands. Keep your belly strong so that you don't let that lower back turn into a back bend. You want the low back long. And then you're going to just open that upper back by bringing the shoulders towards the waist. Take a few breaths. Good, 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 good. Push forward into the heels of your hands. They look good. And now what we're going to do is we're going to take the right foot forward. And you're going to step walk or assist the right foot forward. The assist would be right hand around the right ankle. And now we're in that lunge. We look forward, shoulders towards the waist. That looks great. And then we're going to take an inhale and step the right foot to meet the left. As we breathe out through the nose, we're going to fold over. And now maybe our legs will get a little straighter than when we were doing ragdoll. Ground into your feet. Ground into your toes. Engage your belly. And here we go. Inhale. Come rising up. Exhale, prayer back to the heart. We're going to do one more like that. So inhale through the nose, reach up, stretch up. Exhale, fold over. Inhale, step the left foot back. Low lunge, runner's lunge. Gaze forward. Inhale, take your right foot back. Push those heels back. Pull the belly up. Breathe. Maybe move forward and back a little bit just to play with it.
It's my wrist. I should have brought my braces.
And then inhale. And as you exhale, now if your wrists are bothering you, you can always do things on your feet. Yeah. And then we're going to come. Yeah. And then you're going to come back into child's pose. And again, how do you come forward? I'll do modified push-up this time so we do it a different way, but if you want to do Ashtanga Namaskara, I really like that because it helps my tight upper back. So I'm going to do the other one here just to demo it. So inhale, coming forward, and exhaling down. I'm really using my arms. And then I'm back on my belly. And this time I'll do a cobra without holding onto the mat, which is not something I love to hold for a long time, but here it is. So my shoulders stay down. So you, if that's the case, keep the shoulders down. You might have to keep your elbows bent like I do. And Delaney doesn't have to. She's more bendy. Okay, that's all right. Curl the toes. Inhale, take it up. Downward facing. Adho Mukha Svanasana. Now, in a vinyasa class, and we're taking it slow here, people often like to pedal their feet, right? Like to walk their dog. So if you feel like pedaling your feet, that helps you open up the back of your legs all the way up to your hip socket. Why not? Oh, it's nice. Yeah, it's good. All right, then pull the heels of your feet down and back. We're going to get ready to take the left foot forward. So inhale, take your left foot forward. You're back in your low lunge. Yeah, assisted forward. That's what you got to do. A lot of people have to do that. Assisted forward.
It's my wrist.
And then exhale, and then inhale, step the right foot forward. And exhale, hinge from your hips, fold over. Ground into your feet, engage your belly, engage your legs, and inhale, come all the way up. Exhale, take a prayer. Right on back to your heart. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, fold over. Inhale, step or hop back to plank position. Now, here's our plank. What is chaturanga? Chaturanga is plank. So when you lower down, you want your body to be straight. Your elbows should go no wider than your wrist, your gaze slightly forward, and everything straight, strong, and engaged, right? And then inhale, upward facing dog. Your legs are as straight as possible, and your toes can be flat or curled. Push your chest forward, your belly forward, your hips forward. In other words, just kind of really thrusting that part of your body forward. And now inhale, downward facing dog. And exhale, down dog. Oh, and hold and breathe. Pull the tailbone back, pull the belly in, and do your down dog. Good. Squeeze those arm muscles really nice and strong. Now, when we come forward, we're gonna have the choice to step, walk, or hop. If you're gonna hop, look where you're going. Bend those knees a little bit. And then inhale, take it forward. There you go. Exhale. Now let's take Ardha Uttanasana. Inhale, look forward. Ardha means half of. Half of, forward bend. Exhale, forward bend. Inhale, come up. I'm going to hook my thumbs this time so I can lengthen and extend my spine. And then exhale, prayer to the heart. Okay, now we're going to get a little vinyasa-ish. So bend your knees for chair pose, fierce pose, Utkatasana. Knees and feet may touch or be right under your hips. Bring your arms up. Keep your belly strong. Inhale. As you exhale, fold over. Gazing forward. Inhale. Step or hop back. Exhale. Chaturanga, knees or floor. Inhale. Armpit, chest forward. Legs straight, straight, straight. And exhale. Down dog. Okay. Lift your right leg up. Inhale. Shoot that forward. Exhale. Look at your left foot. Left foot will be angled forward a bit, 45 to 60 degrees, so that when we ground into our feet and legs and get ready to come up, we're going to inhale, come up. We're going to take our hands on our hips, pull the left hip forward, right hip back. Keep belly strong, lengthen tailbone down. I love this song, Blue Sky Mine. Inhale, bring your arms up. Exhale, come forward like so. Palms go up. Inhale, come up. Feel how your legs are grounding you into the earth. Exhale, come down. Inhale, arms. So inhale, bring your arms up. Yeah. Exhale, bring it down. Bring your right leg back up. Inhale, up. Gonna go through a vinyasa. You can take, keep that foot up or not. Exhale, chaturanga, knees or floor. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, down dog. In and through the body. That's what we're hearing now. Inhale, bring your left leg up. No, that's correct. You're fine, Delaney. And exhale, take it forward. And take your right toes forward. And remember, we did this just to get the hip square. Because this hip doesn't want to come forward, but it's supposed to. And then inhale, bring your arms up. Inhale, come up. And exhale, come down. Inhale, come up. Good, and exhale, take your hands to the floor. All right, we're gonna go through our vinyasa. Inhale, bring the left leg up. Plank position. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Stay in downward facing dog. And breathe. Every time you exhale, bring your chest a little closer to your thighs. And your head a little closer to the floor. Now we're going to get ready to take it forward. So you're going to look between your hands, spread those fingers, Miss Delaney. I'm telling you, it makes a difference. It really does. Because when your fingers are like that, it just can put more pressure like on your wrist. So right now you can put like more energy into that whole heel of your hand and in through your fingers. It's just a habit. Once you get in habit, you'll do it. And then inhale. Take it forward. Exhale. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, fold over. We're coming back to chair pose. Bend your knees. Maybe your feet are together. Inhale, the arms up. Hold it. Sit back into the heels of your feet. Reach up. Good. Inhale, exhale. Tadasana. Turn your right toes to the right. Now, the distance between your legs is up to you. I saw a thing on social media recently saying wider is better. I don't kind of agree with that. I think stability is better. So find what's stable for you. And then inhale, bring your arms out to the side. And exhale, bring your right arm down, left arm up, and lengthen your spine over the right leg. Look up towards your left fingers. Great, your legs are straight and strong, and the breath is supporting you as you do your triangle pose. Trikonasana, triangle pose. Good. Now we're going to come up with an inhale. Inhale, come up. Turn your right toes forward or in a little bit, and your left toes face the front of your mat completely. Make your legs really strong. Inhale. Just take the left arm down, the right arm up. That's it. Feel the stretch. Reach up. Breathe. Good. Now inhale, take it up. Turn your feet parallel towards this wall. Now you might widen them a little more. I would. I usually make this one a little wider than I do my Trikonasana, so it's up to you. And then you're going to inhale and you're going to fold over and let your head drop.
So feet are straight ahead.
Feet are straight ahead. So both of you could take your toes in a little bit more. Your feet are parallel. Yeah, that's better. So when your feet are parallel, even a little bit in towards pigeon-toed, you have a lot more equal weight inner and outer ankle and knee, which means more stability, less problems on the joints. Maybe not today, but maybe someday. And then you don't want those problems. So top of the head on the floor, you could take your heels up. You could take your feet up. Do a headstand, like so. Oh, okay, now we've got our stretch. Inhale, walk your hands out. Turn your right toes to the front, step front, fold over into Uttanasana, forward bend. Inhale, come all the way up. Exhale, prayer to the heart. Okay, so here we go. We're gonna take another vinyasa. Inhale, reach your arms up and back. Exhale, fold over. Gazing forward, spread fingers. Inhale, step or hop back. Exhale, chest slightly forward, chaturanga. Gaze slightly forward. Inhale, armpit, chest forward. You can do cobra or sphinx if you don't do up dog. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, take your right leg up in the air. And exhale, shoot it forward. Open up the warrior two. So now your left toe is open, but don't let them face the back of the mat. Bend the right knee directly over the ankle. Come on up. Right arm forward, left arm back. Gaze over your forward fingers. Beautiful. Have your arms nice in line. Yeah, it's good to look at the back one. That looks great. Very good. All right, what some teachers do, and I don't usually do, but we'll do it, is let your palms go up for a moment and feel how that opens your chest just ever so slightly more. Interesting, right? And then your left palm can go down and we'll go to reverse peaceful warrior.
Oh,
Vipariti Virabhadrasana. Right knee bent, right over the ankle. Left knee straight. Good. Inhale, come back. Exhale, right forearm down. This is the simplest version of this. Left arm over your head, palm down. Shoulder towards the ear. No, wrong. Don't do the ear. Shoulder towards the waist. So it's looking at Delaney. Wait a second here, young lady. Let's see here. Take this down here. There you go. No, like see.
Oh, 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 yes, yes, yes.
There you go. See, you know, I'm like shoulder to the ear. No, 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 not shoulder. All right. Yeah. Okay. Very good. Back to warrior two. Inhale. Exhale. Windmill your hands. Inhale, let's go to down dog. We'll make it easy peasy. Exhale, let's go to up dog. Inhale, let's go to down dog. Exhale, we skip the chaturanga. Let's take the left foot forward. Inhale. Now we're opening up. So the right toes, they will open, but don't let them face the back of the mat. The foot's about parallel to the back of the mat. Watch that left knee as you come up. And now the left arm forward, right arm back. See, you've got to look back there because my right shoulder wasn't quite lined up. Look over your forward fingers. Let your fingers dance. And then, broop, we did this, right? Yeah, very dancey. And then the right palm will go back down and we'll inhale and we'll take it back. Yeah, not forward yet, up and back. There we go. Good, good, good. Feel that stretch in our rib cages. Yes, they're speaking to us. And then inhale, come back. Now here's the one where the shoulder goes towards the waist, not the ear. Inhale the arm up, bring it over your head. You know, you were asked about the hand the other day, Delaney. I think it's like mine, where the
open.
Hand is just, yeah, open, but not like too horribly engaged, mm-hmm. You know, but it's not just flopping.
And yeah. What about elbow on the top one? Straighter?
Straight, straight, straight. We had this the other day. It's a flagpole, not a flag. And then inhale, come back. Good. And exhale. All right, we're going to go to plank. Plank. No chaturanga unless you want it. Up dog. Oh, no. Or down dog like Delaney. Let's go to Delaney. Up, down dog. Yeah, very good. Home. This is a song that...
It was your dog that was here last time.
Django.
Okay. Good picture. picture, me and him together.
Yeah, he was great in here. This is the song for my one-woman show. I sang it in North Dakota. Gosh. It's about our ancestors.
Every day is a dance of gravity.
Your heart beat in me. Right? We have the heartbeat of our ancestors right in our chest. Think about it. Look between your hands. Inhale. Step, walk, or hop. Exhale. Inhale, gaze forward. Exhale, fold over. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, fold right back down. Inhale, take your right foot back. Exhale, drop the right knee, toes flat or curled in the back, your choice. Inhale, come up, crescent moon. Exhale, right over to the twist. Get over there as much as you can. Hook the arm to the leg to the arm, and if you're feeling strong, curl your back toes under, straighten the back knee, look up to the ceiling, stack your palms, or whatever you want to do here. And if you stack your palms, try to line your elbows and shoulders up and gaze up towards the heavens. Gaze up, breathe. Strong twist. Good. Yep, back knee can be up or down. All right, let's take it back. Bring those arms up again. Knee up or down. Inhale. Exhale, take it down. Good. Let's take the left knee back. Let's step the right foot forward. Inhale. Press your hips towards the earth. And then come on up. Ground down, lift up just for a moment. Inhale. As you exhale, look it over across. Stacking palms. Back knee up or down, your choice. Good, everybody breathing? I know we're breathing. Are you doing yogi breath? Take your hands back to the floor. No, wrong. Do what we did on the other side. Bring the arms up. Forgot that. Now we go to the floor. Oh. Inhale as you exhale. Okay, come forward. Good. All right, inhale, come up, hook your thumbs if you want to get a nice extension. Exhale, prayer to the heart. Mountain. Eyes open or closed. Okay, now we're going to do a tree pose. And you're going to choose a gaze, and we're on a thick carpet, so it's more challenging. So if you feel like you need a wall, you take a wall. And otherwise, maybe you just see how it goes, right? So, and you take the foot here. If your hips are more open, you can take the foot into the crease of the hip.
Socks too slippery.
Yeah, and socks can be slippery and pants can be slippery. Inside the heart is that eternal space, he just said. Good. Reach out to heaven. I can hold your hand. Nice line. Come back. Okay, now our bodies are not symmetrical. I know this is my wobbly side, so see what you got. So, in poses, it's your entire body. So as I was balancing, I had to use the left arm to help my body be balanced. So every cell in your body, this is not me, it's Mr. Iyengar, is in the pose. So let's come down into crow squat. For our hips, careful of our knees. If your heels have to be up, let them be up. If you have to be on a block, be on a block. And just open up the hips a little bit here. Now we're going to spread the fingers wide. Your knee can either be on your arm or outside the arm. I tend to do mine outside the arm and hug it in. And you want your elbows bent, right, Lainey? So if you do it straight, that's an advanced pose. It is a pose, but it's not the way to learn this. So you bend your knees, you come forward, really two different poses, and your gaze is slightly forward.
This is so weird to me now because it feels like it's pulling my skin off.
Spread your fingers. They're not spread, and you got wrist issues, so spread your fingers. And then
that part.
Good, both of you. And Lisa, your head is down. You'll never get it that way. You have to look slightly forward.
And I know this, but I haven't done it in such a long time.
Yeah, and you don't want, I think what you're doing is great, because you don't want to strain, right? Good, now sit down here. And bring your legs out to the side. We are coming to the ground.
Oh,
I'm gonna do some nice fun stretching here. So you're gonna take your left foot in, your right leg out, and the first thing you're going to do is take your left fingers, go like this, and reach back as much as you can. It feels really good. Reach back. Oh, breathe. I just felt my spine make a noise. And then inhale, and as you exhale, come down. And now twist to the right. You want to keep this leg straight, so knee down, toes up, look back. To the right, bring the left shoulder forward, heart up, shoulders down. Can you see the faces of the mothers of your past, the fathers of your past? Listen, they are calling for your healing. This is one of my favorite songs. All right, and now, of many, and now we inhale, come back. And exhale. So many healing songs, right?
Healing songs.
And then we're going to go to the other side. And again, let's not forget this leg. Spread your right fingers and take your left arm up and reach back. Oh, feel the stretch wherever you need it. You will feel it and breathe as you strengthen the standing arm. Good. And then inhale. And as you exhale, come down and take that twist and look back.
I did it twice on the same leg.
Oh, yeah, that happens too. Heart up, shoulders down. Good. And now inhale, bring it around. And exhale. This is a great hip stretch. I'm going to turn sideways in case we are recording just for fun of it. This is called star pose. So as opposed to going in here, which is another pose, it's out here. And I really like this pose. You lead with your heart and you try to get your face to come to your feet. Real time. So grab yourselves a wheel, and I'm grabbing myself a wheel. This is one of my favorite things because I don't have a very good back bend. And as they say in Sarupa, support equals release. So if you want to release your spine and it isn't doing it very well, let yourself get supported. These are amazing. So you bring your back on it and you let yourself be supported.
Oh, I have a ball at home. I need some.
Well, the balls, a lot of people say that, and that's great, but they're not as firm as this.
That's true.
And they're a little bit different in the size of them. So this is a little like shorter for a lot of times, where you can go down to your lower back, have a little more versatility. Though the balls aren't bad, but I like, because I have such resistance to opening into a back bend in my body, I need something that I feel like when I do the chair, is really hard. I mean, not hard in the difficult, physically hard substance to get my spine going the other way.
Oh,
which is so important because we don't backbend in life, and our spine needs it, and it's good for our lungs, and it's good for courage, and it's good for our heart, and it counteracts all the stuff we do on our devices that is bad for our shoulders and our neck and our spine. Oh, it's right.
I also like redwood trees.
Trees and rocks can do it too. I've done it on rocks and trees also. This is true. Nature's a good thing. After all, yoga's in reverence of nature, right? All right. So now, when you feel like you're ready, I'm going to invite you to come on your back and just hug your knees in. And just give yourself a yogi hug. Oh, give yourself a hug. Breathe. Now, as we drop the legs over, there's many different, not many, but several different ways to do this. There's a classic, just stack your knees. I'm going to do the yin yoga way where I'm going to put my right leg and cross it over, sorry, left leg over my right thigh. And then I'm going to inhale and take the legs over to the right. My left arm is going to reach to the left. I'm going to look to the left. My right arm can do whatever it would like. It might help urge the legs over a little more. And we breathe. And we release the knots of life in our back.
And this is my shoulder that works well.
And breathe. Then we're gonna inhale, come back to center. If your legs are in some kind of a crossed configuration or anything different than stacked, switch it. Inhale. On the exhale, we release. So exhale, release those legs over. Look to the opposite hand, which is not reaching with any big effort. You can relax those fingers. Breathe. Center. We'll do a little happy baby because people seem to like that one, so why not do it because it's fun. Open your knees. Soles the feet up. Hold on to whatever you can. Now the deal with this one is you want to push your tailbone forward and keep your lower back on the floor. This is not a plow pose, right? We might do that next, but right now see if your whole lower back can stay on the floor. If you want to be a rocking baby, a lot of people like to do that. If you do rocking baby, can you gently get your knee to tap the floor? It's kind of a preparation for getting your legs behind your head. All right. Then you come back to center, you pull on it a little bit more, you bring your feet together, and you straighten them up towards the ceiling. See if you can get the back of your knees straight, the feet not over flexed, but a little bit flexed, as if you had a block or a book on your feet. And then from there, we'll take a plow. So before you go to plow, have the back of your head on the floor. So you're not going to try to change your head, right? You're going to keep it where it is, because sometimes people bring the chin to the chest. You want to bring the chest to the chin. That's a pretty important rule. And so that's our plow pose. You try to get right on top of your shoulders. It's a really good preparation for shoulder stand because you can get right on top of your shoulders, the acromion process. You can bend your knees, try to hug your ears or touch the floor with your knees, whatever works for you. But don't go halfway. That's not really, that's kind of nowhere's land. So either really bend your knees and get that or straighten your legs. Right? There's two different poses. Now, if your shoulders are different than mine, you'll try to have your elbow in line with your shoulder. Mine won't do that. They might have done it before when I was younger, but they don't anymore. And then you try to take your hands up your back as high as you can to your rib cage if you can. And you push that back in as you go up to shoulder stand. On the waters, on the inside. That's the way to go. have things like a full lotus, only if you have it, don't force it. Going to come out of this when you're ready. No rush. But what I like to do is take a nice inhale and get each vertebra a little massage as I come out. So that's an exhale, and I just let each vertebra get a little massage from the earth. It feels quite amazing in my body. And then your arms are going to come down and come underneath your body as you go up on your elbows. You push your chest up. Some people can do that much higher than me. I'm not very open here. And then you'll go to the top of your head. No, not everybody can get to the top of your head. But if you're flexible, you try to go towards your forehead. Push the toes away, point them like the tail of a fish, and push your chest up. Matsyasana, the fish pose. And then when you feel like you've had enough fishing for the day, you're just gonna relax and let all the vertebra and your muscles and your bones and your joints relax for a moment. Take a total rest and let all fatigue leave your body. Let all fatigue leave your body. Let your body be in utter stillness.